Listen!
Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephen Quartermain, and welcome to Flinders Park in Melbourne for week 11 of the NBL season. Tonight, it's the Melbourne Tigers playing host to the Adelaide 36ers, 4th versus 8th on the NBL ladder. These teams have already played once this year, and that was back in week 7 on May 20, and the Tigers that night had a 5-point win, 102-97, Gaze 30, Copeland 25, while for Adelaide, Davis shot 24 and McKay 18. Dean Templeton, good evening. Big task for Adelaide tonight because they got to win without Robert Rose, who's obviously their star player.
Absolutely. Robert Rose injured his knee in that particular game against Melbourne, and the 36ers have now brought in big 7-footer Willie Simmons, who last saw action in the NBL in 1989 with the Cannons. And Willie, of course, will be there to play a defensive role and block some shots. There you see him on your screen with the goggles on. He will make a difference, but it'll be hard to slot him in. I can't help but go for the Tigers at home, but you can't, they're a talented lineup, the 36ers or Super Sixers. Who knows what will happen?
Let's have a look at the NBL ladder as it stands at the moment after 10 weeks of basketball. Brisbane on top, North Melbourne second, Perth third, the Tigers, as we said, in fourth spot, followed by Sydney, Magic, Gold Coast and Adelaide making up the top eight. In ninth spot are the Illawarra Hawks. Newcastle 10th, Canberra, Geelong, Hobart and Townsville make up the ladder. Tim Gossage will be running the sidelines tonight. Tim, the Andrew Melinda Gaze baby saga continues.
It certainly does, Stephen. 3 days overdue. The little grub was meant to drop on Tuesday, but Melinda is courtside tonight, but she has all the battle battalion on standby too, in case she has to rush around the corner to St Vincent's Private Hospital. But as far as Andrew's concerned, he doesn't want to know about any prospective young baby on the scene. He wants to play basketball, so it could be a big, big night for the Gaze family.
Let's have a look at the starting fives for the two teams tonight. Andrew Gaze, number 10. Stephen Whitehead, Lanard Copeland, Dave Simmons, and the former Adelaide 36er, Mark Bradtke, and he always fires up for these games against his old team. Starting for Adelaide, Maher, McKay, Blakemore, Davis, and Willie Simmons.
And off the benches for the Tigers, Warwick Giddy, Ray Gordon, Walter, Anstey, and Tenner. And for the Super Sixers, Phil Smyth, Scott Ninnis, Wheeler, Spaldinas, and Hawks.
So crowd of about 10,000 here at Flinders Park tonight. Geez, Dino, Tim was pretty hard on poor old Andrew, saying he wasn't interested in the baby. It came out a little bit incorrectly. Of course he cares, but he said he doesn't want to know until after the game because it makes no difference anyway. But he's certainly feeling some pressure as Drewy. And good luck to him and Melinda too. We hope everything goes well when the baby eventually does come.
Yeah, preferably after the game.
I'm sure Adelaide will be telling him about it if Melinda happens to rush off during the game. They'll be happy to see the end of him.
All's fair in love and war.
Well, there's already been, there is Robert Rose, by the way, who's out injured. There have already been some gamesmanship before this game even starts tonight, Dino.
Yeah, very interesting to see the 36ers, the Super Sixers decided to warm up at the regular end of the Tigers. Of course, the away team has the choice of the warm-up end. And they chose to warm up at the end. The Tigers always warm up. The Tigers didn't like it too much, decided that they were going to stay there for a while. We had a standoff situation, but in the end, the Tigers had to go up to an unfamiliar end. So, first points to the Super Sixers.
Now, is it the Adelaide 36ers? Is it the Sixers or the Super Sixers? Or will we just call them the Crows?
I might just call them Adelaide, because if I keep calling them the 36ers, it's going to cost me a lot of money. I can see that. It's the Super Sixers.
Anyway, we'll call them Adelaide. That'll make things very simple. There's Willie Simmons. I don't know about you, Dean, but Willie looks like he's better suited on the slopes of Mount Buller with those goggles on.
Yes, he's one of the players, of course, in the late 80s. A lot of the big players from America, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, James Worthy, I think Akeem Olajuwon, and of course Willie Simmons decided to don the glasses or the goggles to protect them from stray fingers. Of course, the taller players do tend to get a bit of a whack in the face every now and then.
So, we're away here at Flinders Park. Adelaide in the white strip, Tigers first possession. Here's Dave Simmons. Ooh, Gaze gets a bit of treatment from Willie Simmons early on. The pass to Whitehead, the turnaround jump shot misses, rebound to Blakemore. Quickly, Davis. We're in the number 45 tonight.
usually wears 33. So obviously Singlet's gone missing. I think it'll worry the chairman of the boards too much. Maher, he's got the job as starting point guard now for Adelaide, ahead of Phil Smyth. Davis, the big three-point shot, and it's pure.
Well, that is a big three-pointer for Davis. Of course, over his career, he's been known for as an inside player. With this lineup, he can has the luxury of going to the outside and can hit that three. Simmons travels, throws it down, but it'll be no score as he travels. And he picked up his pivot foot on that drive. Some interesting matchups out there, quarters. Stephen Whitehead is picking up Chris Blakemore, double zero for the Adelaide side, and giving away not so much inches or centimetres,
but inches around the chest.
quite a few kilos.
Well, his nickname's Herc. This Chris Blakemore, the double zero, has got the ball now, and he is a big boy. Rookie of the year last year. Now, 10-second warning buzzer on the shot clock. Davis travels. Quite happy with the call, and I think even Dave Simmons for the Tigers shook his head on that one. But anyway, it's a turnover in favour of the Melbourne Tigers. Gaze shoots over Maher, misses, and the big defensive rebound to Willie Simmons, to McKay. Maher back to McKay, another three-point bomb from Adelaide. Oh, great rebounding by Simmons, and cops one in the face from Dave Simmons. Totally accidental, of course. And pretty obvious foul, however. There's a replay coming up.
Very athletic ability then shown by Willie Simmons. And already starting to stamp his name on the game. Known primarily as a rebounder and shot blocker when he played with both the Giants and the Cannons in the 80s.
Played 113 games and averaged 19 points per game in his NBL career. Davis drives. Slapped out by Bradtke, cleverly, to Copeland, to Simmons, and Dave has travelled again.
Yeah, it's always tough for the big guy to catch the ball on the break. Lanard Copeland decided that David Simmons was the man to give the ball to. He wasn't really prepared for it. Ended up travelling.
Davis to Maher. McKay in trouble, but does well to recover the ball. Pass to Maher. Maher, great pass to Blakemore. Big block from Simmons. Now Gaze. Copeland's free. Alley-oop! Three to two. Adelaide lead. Saw that one telegraphed a fair way from home. Just didn't quite come off, but it was still a handy 2 points to the Tigers.
Blakemore and Willie Simmons clashing there under the basket. Forced travel. Tigers ball from the side. Yeah, it was pretty obvious. I think everybody saw it.
I was winding myself up too.
Yeah, you got a bit excited.
And the lady next to you wasn't too happy about it, of course.
Got a bit of a rude shot. We should better get used to that tonight, I think. Whitehead. Oh, clever pass to Simmons. He's free, but can't knock down the two. Another rebound to Blakemore. So it's somewhat of a flat start here in this game. Davis drives. Good use of the body by Davis, and he's drawn the foul. He'll go to the line for two shots.
And there'll be a foul on Mark Bradtke. It's his first. You see the hand coming across the arm there of Davis, who held the ball back. Good play by him. And quarters, this is the first time that we've had the opportunity to see the Super Sixers this season. So you can't really make a comparison to them with Robert Rosen without, but you'd have to say already they look far more aggressive rebounding-wise. Of course, their front line is much bigger now with Davis, Simmons and Blakemore across there, so certainly is a different structure that they've got. And coach Mike Dunlap has to change his strategy just a bit.
Good work again from Willie Simmons. Gets the pass to Davis.
Plenty of guards in this Adelaide squad with Smyth and Minnis on the bench. And, of course, Rose out injured. And quality guards at that. There's a classic Willie Simmons shot. The little jump hook, baby left-hander.
7-2. Simmons. Whitehead. Good pass to Bradtke. Good, excellent work from Blakemore. Good defensive work and no score for Melbourne. So another chance for Adelaide now. McKay to Maher for three. Great, Maher.
See, it's going to be one of those nights.
10-2.
Well, this is another one of those slow starts that we've been used to with the Tigers. Of course, last week against Magic, we saw them come out of the blocks very quickly, but other than that, they have struggled a lot of the first quarters this year. Big Willie throws that one out of David Simmons. Says, get that out of here.
Gaze.
Willie Simmons is really stunning the dummy. He's had the block.
Where has he been the last few years?
Some rebounds.
Davis, no one near him, misses the three. Lucky break for Melbourne. Now Gaze. Points count. We'll go to the line for the extra shot.
On the subject of Willie Simmons and blocks, he does hold the all-time average. Season average of 3.7, and he hasn't played for a while, so he's certainly in form tonight, Dean, and as you would know, Dean, playing against him all those years ago.
In fact, Tim, the statistics between the two men make very interesting reading, Willie Simmons and Dean Templeton. Can you perhaps go through the couple of years they played against each other?
Thanks. Well, yeah. Willie Simmons certainly did dominate the contest, Stephen, no question about that. In 86, his first year, he averaged 24 points a game. Just as he puts in two more. Well, Dean Templeton, 3.6 in 87. It was Willie, 22 points a game as Gaze drives through for just misses. But the big year was 1988 for Dean Templeton. He finished his career with 0.4 points a game. And Simmons was 18 points. So, Dean, you were not a super sixer in your day.
He has had a particular defensive role in that year, though.
14-5. Will you guys take notice of the game? People do not want to hear that rubbish.
Copeland. Good work from Davis, but Copeland breaks free. The shot drops. 14-7.
I refuse to defend myself. I played that last season on one leg. Coach wouldn't play me, wouldn't trade me. McKay knocks down another two.
This is an excellent start from Adelaide. And we have a timeout here at Flinders Park. And it's the visitors leading 16-7. Halfway through the first quarter here at Flinders Park, and Adelaide off to an excellent start. They lead the Tigers 16-7. Tim Gossage, what do you have to report from that timeout?
Couldn't be happier Mike Dunlap with the early minutes of his team. As Gaze puts in two more. Willie Simmons very happy with the performance from him, and also Chris Blakemore on the board. So far things are pretty smooth in the Sixers camp.
Davis. Big foul on Copeland, no doubt about that one. You can hear the slap from here.
He's a very hard man to guard down in that low block position. They've called that one on Simmons. They really could have raffled it either way. Let's have another look. Six and one, half a dozen the other. David Simmons is the unfortunate tiger, but as Steve has said, no doubt about it. And Davis to the line.
Two misses, but a brilliant rebound from Maher against much bigger opponents. And he wins the ball back for his team. Simmons.
And he's not going to take that shot. That's outside his range. But McKay will take it. Selected for the World Championship team during the week. Mike McKay.
Gaze.
Got to give that off now to Bradtke. Good pick and roll play. Copeland on his own for three. Couldn't finish it. A good offensive set then by the Tigers. 1-4 offense being played by the Adelaide 36ers. Just the one guard at the top. Simmons inside. There's that baby hook again. Couldn't connect. That's a foul. That'll be on Whitehead. And Willie Simmons early. Almost going to count the score, I think. But,
three.
Didn't count it. Simmons to the line.
Phil Smyth about to check in. Is that Dean? What's your comments there? He's in the Australian team but can't start with his own club side. A bit different.
Yeah, well, he's a veteran. Phil's been around for many, many years, and I have no doubt that he'll perform very well in the World Championships, and certainly the team needs as much experience as they can have.
What a record he's got, Dean. Four Olympic Games and numerous World Championships as well. What a great ambassador for the sport he's been.
And wants to keep playing. He'll play till he's in a wheelchair.
He's only 36, he's a baby really, isn't he, Smyth? I wonder how old Willie Simmons is. We had a bit of trouble getting his age before the game tonight.
Well, I don't think Willie would be in his early 30s, might be 32.
Yeah.
He went to school, college in the United States with Karl Malone of the Utah Jazz fame, the mailman at Louisiana State University, and so I figured that they'd be around the same age. There's Mike McKay and Brett Maher on the bench. And Mike Dunlap, the Adelaide coach, really has a luxury there to be able to sub those two guys out and bring in players of the calibre of Scott Ninnis and Phil Smyth. Don't lose a thing.
They're so deep, aren't they, on the bench?
Absolutely. Especially amongst the guards. And of course, Rose out injured. And Simmons, Willie, that is, in for him for tonight's game. Copeland over to David Simmons. He'll have to take that one. Can't connect, but Bradtke underneath should finish it off.
Good strong work from Mark Bradtke. It's 19 points to 11. Just under 4 minutes left in the first quarter here at Flinders Park. Ninnis to Blakemore.
That's a travel.
Good defensive work from Whitehead. Forced the error. So another turnover against Adelaide. There's the replay.
And there's the travel.
Perfect shot.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt about that. Failed to keep that pivot foot planted. And the game is just a little flat at the moment. I think opportunity for either team to break out. There's a good jumping defensive effort then by Mark Davis. And yet another travel. Haven't we seen a plethora of travels so far this game, quarters?
That means a lot, Stephen, if you're having trouble deciphering that. He's been saving that one up.
I'm just astounded that Dean was able to come out with a word like that. He's obviously been walking around a week with an Oxford in the back pocket. That's a dictionary, Dean.
Thought you meant an Oxford scholar.
Smythe's free from three-point range. Short arms it.
There's not a lot of fire out there at the moment. Just said the last Melbourne play. Simmons again short.
Gaze over the top of Smyth. Perfect.
Well, you get the feeling that the Super Sixers have just given Melbourne the opportunity to get themselves back into this game. They really had control of it early, but failed to capitalise. Attempted pass inside to Willie Simmons. He says, give it to me a little bit higher. Gaze on the break. Stops for three. Nothing but net.
And all of a sudden, the emotion that the Tigers desperately love has come into the game, and the Tigers are pumped. 19-17, and Mike Dunlap is none too pleased on the sideline after the Adelaide Sixers had a great start, but they've certainly blown that lead now. Let's try and listen in.
On the offensive boards, defensive boards, you're going through a wall now. You got to get active again. Go to the offensive boards, defensive lane, no way back. You should be going in there, getting that even cheat sheet in there. You can, you got to get some movement. That's one bad scramble. That'd be three passes in the shot. Defensively, three-quarter court. on, man to man. I want you up and in. Up and in, alright? Let's get a shot in the paint. Get a wide open jumper now.
So it's 19-17. And the Tigers are back in it, thanks to about the last 20 seconds produced by Andrew Gaze. Two big three-point bombs. Here's the first one. Just looked at Phil Smyth straight between the eyes and said, I'm shooting over the top of you, Smythe. Three easy points, and here's number two. Pure shooting from Andrew Gaze, who averages 33.5 points per game this season, and his career average is 35 points per game. The most prolific scorer in NBL history, and he's still got a lot of basketball left in him. He's still just 29 this year.
What a great matchup that is, Smyth v. Gaze. I mean, there's two of the all-time legends of the game here in Australia up against each other, and they both had a little smile on their faces there. Two tremendous players and great ambassadors for the game. Oh, Davis for three. It's his second three of the game.
He's up to 10.
And he really is a marvel, Mark Davis, having been in the league for such a long time as an import. Willie Simmons throws David Simmons' stuff out of there one more time.
Smyth for three. Now Whitehead. Nimmis wins it back. Smyth. Svaldinas in for some time. Muscles his way in. No foul forthcoming. Wins it back, Svaldinas. Great work, and the foul is on Whitehead, I would suggest, but strong work from the number 42. Just poleaxed a couple of the Tigers.
Well, Svaldinas, of course, started his career with the Sydney Kings, spent some time with the Hobart Devils, and then a very much publicised move, pre-season.
Six-figure move, we understand.
Well, you might understand it, I can't say that.
He had one foot in the Perth Wildcats door, didn't he, and decided then to go to Adelaide. Just quickly, fellas, in the last time out, Lindsay Gaze asked his team to take the ball up the court, express pace. He said, we're being a little bit too conservative. He said, we can run this team off their feet.
So it's 23-17, just over 1.5 left in the first quarter. And Adelaide lead by 6 and thoroughly deserve their lead in this first quarter.
You can see what Adelaide are doing on that screen, just switching on that every time. Andrew Gaze changed his mind when he got up there. Foul was called on Phil Smyth. It will not be a shooting foul.
Go Melbourne!
A man-to-man defense by the Super Sixers. Plenty of weak side help and some good defense by Davis. Then Smyth comes up with the ball, and this time Adelaide look to run it.
Smyth, good work from Simmons, but Smyth wins it back, gives it back to Davis. And good work from Gaze. To Whitehead. Weaves his way inside, another block from Willie Simmons. Sensational stuff. Bradtke has to throw out the ball high to avoid the hand of Simmons again. No score, Melbourne. Here's a chance for Adelaide. Ninnis alley-oop to Simmons, but it's too high.
And during all that, Robert Rose was on his feet for the entire time, shouting encouragement to Willie Simmons. Sensational. Rose is pumped.
Well, it must have been a fairly high pass from Ninnis, because Willie's 7 foot on the off scale.
Well, that, I think that's just a case of not having played together for such, you know, before, and wasn't quite on the trajectory that Willie wanted. He wanted it up in the air, but maybe not quite that high. But isn't he doing a great job defensively? It must be four blocks that he has already. Just the first quarter, so Willie Simmons really enjoying his comeback to the NBL.
Great screen set by Bradtke, but Gaze can't capitalise on it. Another chance for Melbourne. Bradtke wins the ball back. Forces his way in, a tough left-hander, and knocks it down.
Well, that's a very tough shot, because you could see there that Mark was most concerned about Willie, and already Willie Simmons is starting to intimidate some of those shots. Players are thinking twice.
Last play coming up. 4 seconds left. Smyth to Svaldinas. He'll have to hurry. The old 1-2 to Smyth. And should have shot the ball himself, and he knows it. At quarter time here at Flinders Park, it's the Adelaide Sixers 23 leading the Melbourne Tigers 19. Billy Simmons went on a blocking rampage in that first quarter, and he's one of the reasons Adelaide are in front by 4 points over the Tigers. 23-19. Tim Gossage, what do you have to report?
Mike Dunlap wasn't too happy with that last 21 seconds of the first quarter. He says we've got to be a bit smarter than that. He said we can score in 21 seconds, so let's get smarter throughout the game. He's very happy with the defence, but he wants them to play some tough picks on the likes of Gaze and Copeland. He said they don't like the physical stuff. He said no second shots to the Tigers. And the Melinda Gaze baby update, still no score.
I'm glad you referred to it as a baby this time.
Obviously hasn't experienced the joys of fatherhood yet, Dean.
No, he has not. Whitehead to the free throw line. Well, to the best of my knowledge, he hasn't. Let's have another look at that foul this time. Simmons went after the ball, but definitely got Whitehead downstairs with the body. And sends Stephen to the foul line. And his first point for the evening.
Oh, good work from Warwick Giddy to force the turnover. Put Davis under pressure, and the pass was wayward. So a chance for Melbourne to narrow the gap even further. They're down by three. Gaze. Oh, the assist to Bradtke. Keeps it in, but it's a turnover. Simmons, clever pass to Ninnis. And what a great lead that man has for Adelaide, Scott Ninnis. Gaze. Maher chips in. Good work. Back to Ninnis again. Weaves his way through. Oh, spectacular stuff from Ninnis. What a great athlete he is.
He's such a great open court player. He gets on the break. He's unstoppable. He either jumps over the top of you. He's got such great body control. 7-point lead. Another good defensive play by Davis. Adelaide really are on top of this game at the moment. Defensively, they're doing a terrific job containing the Melbourne Tigers.
They've come out switched on in the second quarter, have Adelaide. Saying that, there's a dispute on whose ball it actually is. Right. It is an Adelaide ball.
No way, no way. That was definitely off an Adelaide foot. You can see that from a mile away. Just watch the replay, fellas. I was right on the spot, Dino.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gossage. That was off David Simmons' foot. On the replay.
And Tim, the television never lies.
It never does.
Body, lock up now.
Good refereeing. Davis, good pass to Valdinus, and the foul is on Warwick Giddy.
Tigers racking a lot of fouls up early. Good pass inside. Warwick Giddy never in position. Lindsay Gaze, coach of the Tigers, in the sideline. Copeland comes back in. Stephen Whitehead sits down. Tigers certainly are just a little flat at the moment, but are known for their slow starts. Maher against Gaze. Kicks it out to Davis. Ninnis and Copeland matching up. And that will be a foul on Lanard Copeland. Again, a good effort then by Scott Ninnis. Saw the opening. Went to the basket. And drew the foul.
Scott Ninnis averaging 15 points per game this season. His career average is 10. Of course, a championship ring with the Magic a couple of years ago. Originally from Adelaide.
Not having the best of years from the free throw line this season at 62%, but proves me wrong. And here's some pressure defense by the 36ers. Good coaching by Mike Dunlap just to mix it up a little. Got some pressure up on the ball, up the court. That'll be a foul on Svaldinus over the shoulder of number 25, David Simmons. So at the moment, Adelaide are making all the play at both ends of the floor. There it was, little doubt about that. Straight over the shoulder.
Simmons.
Oh, great hand then by one of the Adelaide players. Slapped the ball out of David Simmons' hand. He was able to recover it. It'll be a jump ball. Andrew Svaldinus up against David Simmons.
And good work from Simmons to slap it back to Copeland. Chance for the Tigers to score. Simmons just giving him no room whatsoever. A little bit rattled at the moment, the Tigers.
You see them jump over that screen again. Simmons goes straight to the basket, runs over the top of Brett Wheeler. Charging foul and no score. Great defensive effort by the 36ers. There's Wheeler, got there. Well, on the slow-mo, you'd have to say that he was leaning in. You've got to say that he was not there, but that's on the slow-motion replay, easy for us to say.
It's Valdinas. Wheeler gives it to Maher. Shoots over Gaze.
It was always going to be a tough shot. It was good defense, a great rebound by Bradtke. Maybe a little forced in by Brett Maher. Giddy. Adelaide wouldn't be too worried about Warwick bringing the ball up. Here comes Copeland off the screen. Great play by Scott Ninnis. Look, this one gets thrown down. A little conservative there by Scott.
Well, they got the two, and all of a sudden, Adelaide lead by 11. And they really are giving it to the Tigers at the moment. Simmons puts in two badly needed points, but they're playing a physical game, aren't they? But extremely fair, but they're just rattled, Tigers, I reckon, at the moment.
It's that defense. Defensively, they're switching wherever they can. They're jump switching and they're rotating, which means that as soon as one man goes and gets another guy, someone is filling in and helping him. And that's excellent team defense. And all credit goes to Mike Dunlap on drilling these guys to be able to perform like that.
Ninnis, a good pass to Svaldinas. Keeps it in play, just. Maher was frowned to the basket, but Davis couldn't see him. Now rebound to Gaze. Gee, and Maher's sticking to him like glue. Gaze to Copeland's scoring cover. And they get the two. So it's 31-24, margin back to seven.
Tigers look so much better when they run the ball. They've got to get that ball up off the floor quickly. In the half court, Adelaide are able to slow them down and to put extra pressure on them.
Wheeler has the basketball for Adelaide. Ooh, almost.
And you take the chance now. There's got to be someone free.
And yeah. Maher.
Good play. Find the open man. Copeland took the chance defensively and left one of the Super Sixers free. This is another $40.
Bradtke. It's a Tigers ball. 7:21 left in the second quarter here at Flinders Park. The hoodlums. Even the hoodlums look a little bit rattled at the moment. That's the one of the Tigers support groups. Not often you see them without like anything to say.
Look like stunned mullets. I'm sure they'll come back at me for that one, but
I think
come on, boys. Pep yourselves up. David Simmons tries to bank one from the three-point line.
Copeland glides through the air and draws the foul. Double substitution for Adelaide. McKay and Blakemore back in. Ninnis and Svaldinas sit down, and for the Tigers, Ray Gordon into the game replacing Simmons. One of the most popular players with the Tigers fans. And he'll certainly spark them up, no question about that. In fact, Mark Brakey sitting down for a break, not Dave Simmons. My apologies to Dave.
Well, David Simmons has got three personal fouls, and it would have seemed sensible for him to be the one to sit down, but Brakey having a rest. And the Tigers going quite small out there at the moment. In relative terms, 26-34, they're 8 points down.
Bradtke sits down with 6 points and eight rebounds. Turnover. Copeland back to Gaze. Gives it to Simmons. Two, and he'll go to the line for an extra shot. Good play, Melbourne.
Now the boys
Let's
are getting
the boys
fired up. Yep. Now they're getting fired up.
They're not front runners, are they, the hoodlums?
Oh, I don't think so. Have a look at this. Is this teamwork? This is guys who have played a lot of basketball together. Beautiful 3-on-2 fast break situation. Run to perfection.
And all of a sudden the margin's back to 5, 34-29.
That's a reaching foul on Andrew Gaze coming behind. It's his first personal.
And a timeout here at Flinders Park. 6:44 left on the clock in the second quarter, and Adelaide lead Melbourne by 5. Adelaide lead Melbourne by 5 points. Scorers so far in the game for Melbourne: Gaze 11, Copeland and Bradtke have 6 apiece. For Adelaide, Davis has 10, Ninnis 8 and Maher 6. Tim Gossage, what do you have to report?
Lindsay Gaze in that timeout was most concerned with just the turnovers. He said we can get rid of those. He said we're right in this game, and as they are, thanks very much to some tough defence as well, and including that of Ray Gordon.
Simmons, a little left hand hook is very good.
It's very hard to guard left-handers. I mean, you, as basketball players, you're brought up guarding right-handers. You're just not used to it. It'll be a foul on Brett Maher, as both he and Gaze hit the floor pretty hard. You get used to guarding guys who are right-handed, and all of a sudden you play against the lefty, and they go the wrong way. Pretty heavy clash then. Definite bump on Brett.
What do you mean, wrong way?
Well, Molly Dukas, they go the wrong way. Don't tell me you're a left-hander.
Correct way.
Of course he would be.
Say no more.
Of course he would be.
That explains a lot. Andrew Gaze, that's his first point. First 2 points for this quarter, up to 13. Had 11 at the quarter break. So a bit better spread of scorers this quarter for the Tigers. Simmons and Simmons inside against each other.
Six. Yeah.
Fouls on Giddy, his second, and a one-on-one situation for Mark Davis. And his foul shooting has not been good tonight. Four from seven.
Oh, good defensive effort by Davis. It's a 3-on-1 situation. Davis goes all the way. Gaze fouls him. As big Willie Simmons came over the top of Warwick Giddy. But the foul was earlier than that. There you see it. A little doubt about that. And Davis has yet another chance at the line. He has been to the line 7 times. He has had 7 attempts from the line. Steve has made just the 4. That's a Burrow performance by Mark Davis.
So 38-31, Adelaide by 7. Copeland. To Gaze. Giddy. Now Copeland. Back to Gordon, a 3-point specialist. He loves those, Ray Gordon. We've seen him do it so many times. And he responds to the occasion, does Gordon on that occasion. 34-38. Margin cut back to 4. Off the ball, a little bit of how do you do between Gordon and Blakemore.
And that's been going on for some time, and there was a little dip of the head from Blakemore against Gordon. Gordon backfired with the left elbow. I tell you what, they didn't connect too heavily, but Dean, it's something that you were used to in your day, my son. It's uncalled for.
Interesting description, the dip of the head. And Blakemore is going to have a rest. Scott Ninnis comes back in, so Mike Dunlap now going with 3 guards out there, Maher, McKay and Ninnis. And it's probably a little bit better matchup for both teams. And Giddy inside against Davis, and Simmons against Simmons. Big Willie Simmons this time grabs the rebound, hooks it back in for two. That one came down near his knee. But isn't he having effect, Simmons? 9 points.
And 8 rebounds and 3 blocks. That is one hell of a game so far. 40-34, Adelaide by 6. Gordon to Gaze. Gaze drives. Oh, what a block from Simmons! Oh, Gaze for three!
Well, might have been a nice block.
Cost him a point.
Cost him a point.
Yeah, it was a tough shot too. That's Gaze's third three-pointer. He's shooting at 100% from the three-point arc, and he's up to 16 points.
He certainly loves that spot on this court, doesn't he? Baseline right. I think the Wildcats are still having nightmares.
Gee, he was up there for that. It's not some... I mean, I know it's easy for him because he's 7 foot tall, but the point is it's the timing. He really gets up there with perfect timing. And it is an art form in itself, blocking shots, and Willie Simmons certainly has truly learnt that art form.
And Giddy has registered his third personal foul already for the game. So he'll just have to be a little bit careful. Both he and Simmons on 3 fouls for Melbourne. No serious foul troubles at all for Adelaide at this stage. Davis already has gone to the foul line 11 times in this game. Four points of difference.
The Tigers really have to get Lanard Copeland involved in some offense. There's just the 6 points at this stage. Doesn't seem to be getting enough of the ball. There's a foul off the ball. It'll be on Mike McKay.
Foul call on number 10, Mike McKay, first foul.
It's a one-on-one situation. And Gaze will have the opportunity to increase his personal score and the score off his team. Up to 17 already, Gaze, so he looks like he's going to be well and truly on his average tonight's game.
Gaze up to 18 and the margin now just 2. Remembering Adelaide did lead by double figures early in this second quarter. McKay to Simmons was a very good pass. I beg your pardon, to Davis was a very good pass. And he knocks it down for 2 more. So Davis is up to 15. Gaze for another 3. 4 from 4 at the 3-point line. He's up to 21. And Adelaide lead by 1.
And you could see the frustration in Brett Maher's face. But there's not much you can do about that. I mean, it gets bumped off, fair enough. As Ninnis puts in a great basket as he grabbed his own rebound, knocked it back down. It is terribly frustrating to guard Andrew Gaze. You really, he's almost impossible to stop. You have to accept the fact that he's going to get a lot of points. And you just have to get on with playing your own game. Bradtke from the foul line can't connect. Willie Simmons grabs that one way above the rim.
Maher off the foot of Gordon.
Well, that one would have been appropriate for the World Cup starting this weekend. Excellent shot on goal. Mike Dunlap, coach of the Adelaide Super Sixers, came over from the States earlier this year.
3-on-1 here. Gordon to Bradtke. And that is a terrible mistake by the Tigers. 3-on-1, they had Copeland, Gordon and Bradtke. And they've turned the ball over, and that is, well, it's about unforgivable, isn't it?
Well, that's the sort of drill that they run at training probably for 20 minutes a night.
Timeout called with 2.5 minutes left on the clock in this second quarter, and it's 45 to Adelaide, 42 to Melbourne. Davis, wearing the number 45 singlet tonight, has 15 points. Gaze has 21 for Melbourne.
Two men, let's go.
been discussing some offensive sets with his players, and what he's talking about there, Quarters, is that jump switching that Adelaide are doing. He wants, as the centre comes out and sets a screen, his man is jumping out to guard the guy with the ball. So what Lindsay is saying, once, as soon as that centre sets the screen, he should run straight to the basket. He should be free for two. That's the theory. We've got to see how it goes in practice.
So Adelaide have possession. They lead by three with just under 2.5 left in the second quarter. Maher. Oh, great rebound from Davis. Well done by Gaze to get a hand of the ball. Maher wins it back for his team. Gets the pass to Ninnis. Ninnis to Davis. Davis shoots over the top of Gaze. Basket counts and a foul on Gaze.
Well, Adelaide certainly deserved a score, and that was a sensational rebound that Davis took. The timing of his leap was magnificent. That's the third personal on Gaze. He's not happy about it.
You'd want the same call. You want the same call on your shot, I'm sure. One.
A good comment then by the referee. Asked Andrew Gaze whether he'd like the same call. He said, you'd like it. Andrew said, yes, of course I would. But
Davis having a great game. McKay. This is what he probably should have made. Anyway, chance for Melbourne. Gaze weaves his magic. points to A. Gaze. Substitution, Phil Smyth coming back on, giving Maher a rest.
Well, they're just going to have to keep rotating guys on the Gaze and hope that they find an answer. I mean, there's not going to be a complete solution. It wouldn't matter if you put the whole team on him. He has 23. The next high scorer for the Tigers has 6, and that's Copeland and Bradtke. He's outscored the rest of the team.
Davis. Again, Simmons out-rebounds Bradtke. But it was a poor pass, and they turn the ball over. Gaze again. Don't tell me he's going to go for three from there, and he changes his mind. Bradtke. Giddy to Gaze.
Oh, that's a tough call. That is a tough call. Really, on that one. He's not at all happy. Let's have another look at it. Seemed to be a pretty clean little slap there.
Perhaps a bit of an Academy Award there too. Just accentuated that any little bit of a foul there. It's all about experience, isn't it?
That's exactly right. Davis and Whitehead. Sorry, Simmons and Whitehead sitting on the Tigers bench. Chris Anstey. Gaze up to 25. Tigers 46. Adelaide 47. 50 seconds remaining. First half.
Ninnis to Simmons. Smyth. Trying to find Davis. He does. Well, great pass to McKay, but the block from Bradtke. Gaze, clever to Gordon. Can he keep it in? He can. And Copeland. But Copeland spills the beans. Another chance for the Sixers.
I'll look just for the one shot here. Steve? 10 seconds remaining.
Davis, the big three. In and out. Gordon to Gaze from half court. At halftime here at Flinders Park, it's the Adelaide Sixers 47, 1-point leaders over the Melbourne Tigers 46.
We're number one trampolinist in Australia, ranked third in the world. Where are we up to? The crowd. Does anyone in the crowd want to have a go at this? We got anyone in the crowd? Anyone? Oh, this guy over here, would you like to have a turn? Yeah, come over. Come over. Put your hands together for this gentleman. The trampoline, yes sir. Where'd you get those glasses? What's your name, young fella? Daryl. How you going, Daryl? Take your glasses off, mate. You got a ticket for tonight's game, Daryl? Daryl, do you have a ticket for tonight's game? Doesn't matter. A bit bouncy, isn't it? Oh. You right there, Daryl? Do you want to do a somersault? Try a somersault. Have you got life insurance? Oh. Have you got life insurance, Daryl? Are you with A&A? Oh, put your hands together for our member out of the crowd. Uh-oh. No. Do you want Daryl to try and dunk it? No, I don't think so. No. Can someone get Daryl off the tram, please? Michael, can you get Daryl off the tram? Daryl, you're going to have to get off, mate. Daryl. Daryl, you're going to have to get off, mate. Please. We need to attempt something quite spectacular. Michael, can you get him off, mate, please? We've got to get on with the act. Uh-oh. Oh. Can you get him off, please? Oh, yep. Throw him off. Throw him off. Throw him off. Daryl, you're going to have to get off, mate. You're going to get hurt. You're going to get hurt, mate. Uh-oh. Oh. Someone help him off. Give him a round of applause. Daryl, get off there. Ladies and gentlemen, what we're here for tonight, Michael Johnson will now attempt a world first. He's going to dunk it from beyond the three-point line. Good luck. Good luck. Uh-oh. Oh. Can he do it? Do you want to have another try? I think he can do it. Round of applause if you want to have another try. Do you want him to shoot it? Do you want him to pass it? Do you want him to slam it? There we go. Oh my. Good luck. Timing is major league important. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands. The fuse is lit and I'm about to go boom. Mercy, mercy, mercy me. My life was a cage, but on stage I'm free. Hyped up, psyched up, ready for wildin'. Standing in a crowd of girls like an island. I see the one I wanna send. Come here, cutie. I flip around. Put your hands together, Michael Johnson from Acrobatic Insanity. Girl, you're about to hurt somebody. Hold up, yo, let's get just one thing clear. There's only one.
At half time, a very spectacular act indeed. Michael Johnson dunking from the three-point line with the help of a trampoline. Spectacular stuff, Dino, wasn't it?
Oh, it was most spectacular. You don't quite get the distance there on the TV. It was a huge distance. Very dangerous. Michael Johnson, tremendous performance. I bet you a few teams would love to sign him up. Unfortunately, they'd have to sign his tramp up as well. That's
47-46. Adelaide beat Melbourne by a point. Top scorers so far. gaze. 25. Look at that. 25 points. And not much from the rest at the moment. Copeland and Bradtke 6, Simmons 5, Gordon the 1 3-pointer. And Davis is doing a great job for Adelaide. He's got 17, Ninnis 10, Simmons, as in Willie, has 9, Maher 6, and McKay been pretty quiet by his standards, just the 2. Gaze starts off the possession in the third quarter. Copeland off the glass. Start. Tigers, and for the first time in the game, Melbourne lead by 1.
And that's exactly what Lanard Copeland would have wanted, a start like that. And the Tigers really do need him to step up. Gaze is having a huge game. He does need some support. Brett Maher answers with a three-pointer down the other end. Willie Simmons, Steve, is not only having a good game offensively with 9 points, he also has 11 rebounds and 4 blocks. So welcome back to the NBL, Willie, as he picks up and makes the assist pass to Mark Davis for an easy 2.
Dean, would he be a bit suspect in these late minutes of the second half, would you think? You know, I don't know what he's been playing in the last couple of years, but will he start to, fitness start to run out, do you think?
Well, I don't know what he's been playing either. I assume he's been playing State League in Adelaide. He looks to be in pretty good shape, and you'd think that he'd come in to a game such as this in pretty good physical condition. So
he's probably been working with him, hasn't he, since Rose?
Yeah.
Did the knee.
Well, you have to wait 3 weeks when a player is put on the waivers. As Copeland makes a 3, so a great start for Copeland in the second half. You have to wait 3 weeks, and there's Robert Rose on your screen, before you can play another player with an injury. When a guy goes out with an injury, Davis inside. That'll be the 4th personal foul on David Simmons. So trouble for the Tigers.
Here's a replay.
Saw that right knee, which was flexed then. No doubt that he hooked Mark Davis with that.
So Adelaide lead by a point. There's Blakemore. Rebound to Bradtke. Gives it to Gaze. Bradtke to Gaze. Fouls on Blakemore. Gee, his body cops some punishment, doesn't it, Dean?
He throws himself around and goes where very few would dare go. But his results certainly make up for it.
Gaze for 2. Not this time. Fouls on Willie Simmons. That's his 3rd personal. I beg your pardon, that's his 2nd personal foul. Another chance for the Tigers to regain the lead. Fouls on Davis this time.
Well, some close checking there by Adelaide. The referee's deeming that the hands were in. A foul against Davis. Inside to David Simmons against Blakemore. Bradtke thinks twice about going against Simmons, and you can just credit that one to Willie Simmons' earlier defense. Gaze this time comes up with it, misses the lay-in, and a foul will be called Willie Simmons, and that's his 3rd personal. So a bad outlet pass led to Willie Simmons' 3rd personal. So a couple of lapses there by the Sixers. Gaze doesn't miss from the free throw line, at least not tonight. He's 8 from 8 from there, up to 26 points.
Melbourne lead by 1, 53-52. In the early part of this 3rd quarter here at Flinders Park, in front of a crowd of just about 10,000. McKay, it's been very quiet.
Blakemore has to finish inside there. That's a better effort by the big fella. Used his size to his advantage. Little jump hook over the top of Whitehead, who had no option other than to foul him. Have a look at there. There's good position. And excellent play by Chris Blakemore inside. Chance for a 3-point play. Not much of a chance of a 3-point play from that free throw. free throw attempt. The Tigers have come up with the ball from the side. Mike Dunlap having a word to referee Scott Cogley.
I'm not going to enter into it then, are you pleased to know?
No comment on that one, Tim.
Simmons, 22.
Back to a one-point lead for the Tigers. Blakemore. And he scores against Whitehead again. So Stephen Whitehead has his hands full with Chris Blakemore, and they're certainly looking for him down there, Steve. He's working well against the smaller Stephen Whitehead.
Keep an eye on the two big 50s too, Simmons and Bradtke.
Good assist. Oh, what a block from Simmons again.
Almost blocked the dunk.
Maher for three. Bradtke wins the rebound. Quickly to Dave Simmons. To Copeland. Copeland weaves his way in and draws the foul.
It's a foul on Davis as he came over the top. It's his second personal. Good play by Copeland. Just prior to that, we saw Willie Simmons complete his fifth reject or block, which is a tremendous personal milestone. And we're just early stages of the third quarter, so anything can happen for Big Willie. He really is having an impact on the game. Copeland up to 12, make it 13, has 7 this quarter already.
Davis. Bradtke gets a hand on it, but it will be an Adelaide ball from the side. Maher back outside to Ninnis. Back inside to Blakemore, who's really using his muscle against Whitehead to good effect at the moment. Draws another foul. And that's his fourth personal, so Blakemore is winning that little battle quite comprehensively at the moment.
Ray Gordon did a top job on Blakemore, which upset him and saw Blakemore off the court in the first half. Maybe they might be calling on him shortly, do you think, Dean?
Well, Tim, it's a matchup problem for Lindsay Gaze. Blakemore is primarily a centre. We see a foul there on Mark Bradtke. Unfortunately, Chris is not one of the best free throw shooters around, just 1 from 3 from there so far tonight. But he is primarily a centre and a very strongly built player, as we can see. Stephen Whitehead, although around the same height, is more of a perimeter type of player. There's the push out by Mark Fredkin, who's called for that foul. And there's an unusual call on this time by referee Robbie Barnett, a 5-second violation against the Super Sixers, failing to get the ball into court within a 5-second time.
Whitehead, gee, they're putting some pressure on him at the moment. Copeland to Whitehead. To Bradtke. To Simmons. And down it drops. And draws the foul. And Big Willie Simmons loses the goggles. Courtesy of Dave Simmons' elbow. All accidental, of course.
Well, you can see there again, David Simmons was well aware that Willie Simmons was in a position to block his shot. Held the shot back, moved his body into Willie Simmons. Willie was not in position and picked up the foul. Davis somehow gets the ball out to Ninnis. Willie Simmons has gone to sit down and Andrew Svaldinas is coming for him. Davis crashes into Bradtke. Blakemore comes up with the ball. Heavy clash.
10-second warning buzzer on the shot clock. They'll have to hurry. Good pressure defense from the Tigers. Oh, Whitehead gets a hand on the ball. Blakemore will have to hurry. Troubles. Great work, Tigers. Forced the error.
And Melbourne lead by two and have a chance to extend that gap now.
This game is getting very tough, and I reckon things might explode in the next couple of minutes. These teams are trading some pretty tough stuff under the bucket.
It's a good hard game. Blakemore chips in. Interception, really. Ninnis off a hand of the Tiger, and a good call from the ref. Crowd didn't like it, but it was a correct call.
That's a little sloppy on the break then by Adelaide. Might have been a better option for Scotty Ninnis to go all the way with that one. Need to get some motion without the ball. Looking for Blakemore down low again. And now Tigers well aware that they are doing that. And in that particular case, Lanard Copeland was sagging back to pick that pass off. Collected it with his foot. Foot violation. Davis up against Gaze now. Gaze switches and finds Maher. Ninnis against Copeland. Back to Maher. Seldinas inside against Bradtke. Great drive by the young fellas. Seldinas collects for two, but assist there to Brett Maher. Made that basket.
Gaze to Whitehead's free in three-point territory. Had all done. Excellent work, Steve Whitehead. Where were the defenders?
Bread and butter. Easy hoop for Stephen Whitehead.
Davis takes on Simmons, drives. Big reject from Bradtke, but a foul is called. And Mr. A. Gaze has four personal fouls now next to his name.
Well, let's just consider what's happened here on this play. We have another look at it. Davis did well. Well, that's a tough call. I mean, what does a guy have to do?
With established position, had his
hands
in the air.
Well, he was just standing there. I mean, that should be no call. Tim Gossage, you're down close to that. What did you think of that play?
Yeah, very tough call, Dean. But, Andrew Gaze, well, he took it in his stride, as he always does, with a frown on his face and a couple of words to say to the ref.
Look, back to what I was saying. Let's consider the situation. Gaze for, Simmons for, Whitehead for.
Goaltending against Davis, the ball had hit the glass.
Yeah.
And you can't do that.
Well, that's way down. All have four fouls. Those three players have four fouls for the Tigers. Let's go to a break with the Tigers. 64, Adelaide 60.
Halfway mark of the third quarter, there's the score on your screen. Tigers lead Adelaide by four. Gaze, just 2 points in this quarter so far, but Copeland, Dean, has picked up his slack.
Yes, Copeland's up to 13. That's a seven this quarter. Much needed by the Tigers. They cannot, you know, expect to rely on Andrew Gaze to score all the time for them. There's a free player inside Svaldinas, but a good hand then by Mark Bradtke. Travel called on Andrew Svaldinas. Big turnover against the Super Sixers. And a chance here. Lanard Copeland brings the ball down. Davis picks him up. Copeland looking to attack all the time. Doesn't get the roll.
The line here.
Tigers ball.
Turnovers. Well, that's too many by the Tigers standards. 17 to 14, but they are in front.
It's really too many for both teams. And they're crucial. It's the timing of them that's probably just as important.
Gaze. The glass won't go. Davis wins the ball. He's had an excellent game for Adelaide. When you think of rumours floating around early in the season, he was considering giving it away. Blakemore. That's a tough shot.
Gee, hasn't Blakemore stepped up this quarter? Up to nine, has seven this quarter.
I think Mr. Giddy or Mr. Gordon will be coming in very soon, Dean.
Good call, coach, because Warwick Giddy has just got up off the bench ready to come in. And there's no doubt that he'll be coming in to guard that man, Chris Blakemore. Davis. Geez, Svaldinas was open inside underneath. Blakemore again, he's got the confidence going. And another foul this time on Whitehead. That'll be his fifth.
And a frustrating night so far for Steve Whitehead.
Well, he just isn't able to guard Chris Blakemore. It's a mismatch. He's far too strong for him.
So the Herc is at the line. Rookie of the year last year. And boy, could the Adelaide Crows do with him at the moment on the halfback flank.
it'd be the whole back line. Have a look at the size of that chest. Barrel.
So that's been a foul shooting from Blakemore. He's got 11 points and it's 64 apiece. Just under 5 minutes left in the third quarter. So it looks like we're set for a thrilling finish here at Flinders Park.
Gaze has run off about three screens there. Smyth stayed with him somehow. Bradtke finds himself free underneath. Great pass by Copeland.
And he's really lifted in this quarter, Copeland. He's got 7 points in this turn. Davis. Simmons to Copeland. He's got Gaze to his left. Some fancy footwork from Lanard. Assist to Gaze. Oh, and Andrew Gaze spilled it under, dropped it in the goal square. But it's a foul, fortunately for the Tigers, against Svaldinas.
Yeah.
Bit of bad luck for Andrew. Both Andrews. There's a little foul and a lucky break for the Tigers.
Piece of soap, just could not.
Got the handball in the goal square and
almost fell over. Most unusual. I suppose after Copeland had found his way to the basket, Andrew may well have been expecting the shot to go up. It's history now. Gaze is up to 28. Tigers 3 points in front. Make it 4, 11 of 11 from the free throw line for Andrew Gaze.
And he's also 4 from 5 at the 3-point line. 68-64. Tigers by 4. McKay kicks it back out to Blakemore, but it's a 2-point shot. And Blakemore, is he having a quarter and a half?
11 points this quarter for Chris Blakemore. So far, the substitution of Warwick Giddy for Stephen Whitehead has not worked. Gaze finds the lane, goes all the way, scores, picks up the foul on Chris Blakemore. You cannot give him an inch. Look at that, just found the lane all the way. Blakemore attempted to come across to give help, couldn't get all the way there. Made contact, sent Andrew Gaze to the foul line yet again.
And it was interesting looking at the Adelaide coaching bench then. The three coaches there just looked at each other and said, well, what can you do? Tried just about everything. Bad turnover against Adelaide. So the momentum just slightly shifting in favour of the Tigers. They're now out by 5. Another basket here would make it very tough for Adelaide. Simmons! Timeout called by Adelaide. And the crowd has found its voice and the Tigers are pumped up as they head to the bench for this timeout. Big play from Dave Simmons and the margin all of a sudden is out to 7 in favour of the home team. Gaze 32, Copeland 13, Simmons 11. And this is point number 10 and 11 for Simmons. For Adelaide, Davis has 20, Blakemore 13 and Ninnis 10. Let's try and listen in on Mike Dunlap, the coach of Adelaide, if we can. Pretty noisy here. What do Adelaide do now, Dean?
Well, they've really got to try and find some way to shut Gaze down. Well, not so much to shut him down, but to slow him down, make it harder for him, try and keep the ball out of his hands, but how they do it, I don't know. Maybe they could use a truck, but I can't think of a brand name of a truck just at the minute. Thank you very much, Stephen. But quite seriously, they need to slow the Tigers down. When the Tigers get in this mood, they run the ball up the floor. They're an excellent fast-breaking team. Adelaide need to slow it down, get the tempo back to the tempo that they wish to play. And it's classic Tigers. Slow start. The momentum builds. The emotion comes into the game. All the players start to get involved, led by that man, A. Gaze. And all of a sudden, you look at the scoreboard, and they're not 11 down.
They're 7 up.
Please do not throw anything onto the court.
Tim Gossage, anything further to add?
It was very, very hard to hear what was going on in that timeout with Mike Dunlap. He did say we've got to put pressure on Gaze right from the word go. Don't let him get over half court. As soon as he gets possession of the ball, attack.
Nidus for three. Short arms it. Now Gaze has got the ball again. He's got Copeland to his right. Simmons to Bradtke, storming down the middle. And the Tigers are on fire.
Fast break basketball, classic style. The big fella trailed all the way. Ends up with the ball, scores two.
Nidus, 3 point.
Well, all of a sudden the pressure is on the Adelaide shooters now. Their arms are getting stiff. They've got to make these baskets. They don't have the luxury of a lead. They must knock them down. The freewheeling Tigers can just take it. Nothing to lose.
Giddy to Copeland. Underneath. Spectacular!
What a catch. He's caught that about six rows back.
And they are on a scoring rampage. They're out by 11.
And Willie Simmons hoping to check back in shortly. Yes, having the floodgates open here.
Blakemore charge. So nothing going right for Adelaide at the moment.
Have a look at this break. Bradtke gives the ball to Gaze. He goes to Simmons. Simmons fakes it. We didn't catch it, but Bradtke trailed all the way. He started the break and he finished the break. Classic play by the big fella.
So Melbourne by 11, 77-66. 2 minutes left in this third quarter. Adelaide need to do something pretty fast. Otherwise, this is going to slip away from them. Still a long way to go, though. Gaze alley-oop is too high for Simmons.
I reckon the guy at halftime might have just caught that one. Maybe. That's the guy on the trampoline.
So Adelaide really need to score at this trip up the court. Ninnis to Maher. Maher's free, off the glass, that was pretty easy.
Nothing's easy for the Sixers at the moment, that was a tough hoop and he had to knock it down. Giddy, left all alone, setting up in their half court play. Here comes Simmons off the first cut, Gaze off the next, not looking for him. Offensive foul. On David Simmons, that's his fifth personal. Let's have another look at that. Very hard to tell from that angle. Not copping out on that, but you could not see whether Simmons was moving laterally. The referee was in a very good position to make that call.
Well, they're going to go at Simmons now because he's got five fouls, and this could be big trouble for the Tigers because they really do need his height on the court. Blakemore. Fighting for the ball, that five players, Simmons wins out for Melbourne, gives it to Gaze. Less than a minute left. Copeland to Giddy. Gaze, oh, great move. And
well, the guy moves so well without the ball. This is a, well, I mean, I know he's such a fabulous player, but his main secret is he doesn't have to have the ball to beat you. He didn't have it then. He took his man out, went back door, got the ball free, makes the basket. I mean, he's just a tremendous mover without the basketball and an absolute lesson for anyone wanting to take the game up.
So Adelaide will work the clock down and have the last shot of the quarter, and they really need to nail it. Maher inside to Blakemore, spills it with 3.4 seconds left in the third quarter. So what will the Tigers try? Gaze, back to Giddy from half court. Oh, looking far away. So three quarter time, the Tigers have control of this basketball game. They lead Adelaide by 11 points, 79-68. Final quarter just about to start here in Flinders Park. The Tigers, 11-point leaders over Adelaide, 79-68. Gaze, 34 for Melbourne. Davis, 20 for Adelaide. Tim Gossage, anything to report?
Lindsay Gaze was just stressing the importance to do all the things that's got his team in front so far. He said when they've got the ball, he said push the ball up the court. He said because Adelaide, if you give them time to set, they could certainly get themselves back in this game. He said the tempo has to be dictated by the Melbourne Tigers.
Well, so far the game is all the elements of a classic Tigers game. They were 4 points down at the quarter, and since then they have outscored the Super Sixers 60-45. So slow start, but they've warmed up to the task, and at the moment seem to be in control.
Bradtke gets past Simmons, picks his moment, and just a little tap just to make sure.
Sixers need a couple of breaks. They need to connect on a couple of perimeter shots, maybe. Pick up Simmons' sixth personal. That'd help. There's a chance. Maher makes three. That's what they need. 71-81. Need a stop here. Giddy bringing the ball up for the Tigers. Most unusual. Bradtke catching the ball inside far too easily. Needs to have more pressure on him. Simmons gets a shove from Davis.
Some fancy footwork there from Mark Bradtke. Shooting percentages excellent from both teams at the three-point line.
Very good.
They've both been fairly selective, haven't they, with their three-point shooting?
There's Copeland looking for Mark Bradtke on the roll. Misses him. Throws it out of court. Ninnis all the way to the hoop. Can't connect. Good defense by Mark Bradtke.
Copeland back to Simmons. And two more points to Dave Simmons. 83-71, so it's out to 12 points of difference.
Well, Simmons has certainly picked up his work rate. Failed to score in the first quarter. Now has 13. Add to that six rebounds. Davis short for three. Gaze off for the break again. He'll go all the way. No, gives it to Simmons. Beautiful pass. Assist Andrew Gaze. And Gaze once again dictating the terms and the tempo of the game.
Timeout here at Flinders Park. Adelaide are in trouble. They're down by 14 against the Tigers. Minutes left in the final quarter, and Mike Dunlap, the coach of the Adelaide, you saw on the screen there, is a worried man, and he's got reason to be because his team are 14 points down against the Tigers. McKay.
Mike Dunlap, sorry, who's down there? It's McKay.
It seemed to come down on an elbow or a wrist. Yeah. Oh, this could be nasty. It's a wrist.
And it looks good to me. Let it go, then there was a collision.
See if we can see it. Always dangerous when players are falling. Of course, your natural instinct says put your hands out.
He looks okay, which is good news.
Mike Dunlap in that timeout asked for a bit of discipline from his team. He said two of the three buckets quickly from the Tigers were layups. He said some of the blokes are just loafing down the court, and he wants more from Willie Simmons. He's been unsighted almost since halftime.
Now, gee, that's a tough call by the coach. A guy's been sitting on the bench for half the second half. But still, I think he's done a tremendous job for his first game in. But fair enough, coach. Got to get on these guys.
I think he's just trying to pep them up, Dean, and I think he's looking to Simmons to be the go-to man here.
Well, they do need him. He has not scored. You're quite right. He hasn't scored this second half. Defensively, they need him out there. Spot some of those shots.
Maher shoots over the top of Giddy and it's effective.
Maher's having a great game, 16 points personally.
80-70-75. Gaze foul.
Had a touch of trouble defensively though.
That'll be Willie Simmons' fifth foul also.
And there was not much doubt about that one.
Well, Andrew Gaze is just so aware of what is happening around him. It's, I know we continually are speaking about how good this guy is, and people must get sick to death of it, but it's the facts.
Mike McKay having some magic spray put on the right wrist. The right wrist. And Stephen Quatermain, pats on the back for you. Official attendance tonight, 10,000 exactly.
Maher for three. Oh, should be a pushing foul on Blakemore. Nudge goes right in the middle of the back.
That's his fourth personal.
So the Tigers by 14. 8.5 left in the game. Really dictating the terms now. Gaze, nowhere to go, so shoots. Oh, that's a tough call.
I think this one might be changed. Ray Hunt coming over to Scott Copeland. May have had a better view of it. Yes, decision is changed. Good refereeing. Ray Hunt, the senior referee. Over the top, you see, Bradtke seems to get a hand on that. And Ray Hunt.
Still reckon the other ref is in the better position.
Well, he may have been. It seemed to be an Adelaide ball. Justice was done.
Davis works his way inside.
Tough move.
Yep.
Can't guard that.
Gaze shows some great ball handling skills. Runs into a wall of Adelaide defenders, but wins it back.
It was amazing. He just knew where David Simmons was. Comes back up with the ball somehow.
Gaze to Bradtke. Bradtke, the little right arm hook. Simmons keeps it in. No, he doesn't. It's an Adelaide ball. 12 points, Tigers lead. 7.5 left in the game. Still plenty of time left for Adelaide. Stranger things have happened. We've seen it, haven't we, Dean?
Yes, I've refused to make any sort of predictions. Ninnis will take the three-pointer. No, chooses to go all the way. Lovely drive.
That's back to 10.
Adelaide need to get a stop, and they need it here. That's a great shot over the top of Willie Simmons by Lanard Copeland. Copeland up to 17. And every time the Sixers seem as though they're going to threaten the Tigers. Well, there's a foul on Andrew Gaze. It'll be five personals. Now this throws a new complexion on the game.
Tigers want a timeout also.
And they get it. 91-79, so 12 points of difference, but the Tigers have some serious foul problems. There's, as we said, there's almost 7 minutes left in the game. Gaze, Simmons and Whitehead all have five fouls. So, you know, if Andrew Gaze fouls out, well, it changes the whole complexion of the game. Here's Lindsay Gaze.
Time when I open up those five lanes down the middle for the pass play. Got to keep a wedge behind the ball. Like, I mean, when Minutes went through...
Hayes has 36 in the game. Copeland and Simmons 17 apiece. Bradtke 14 for Melbourne. While for Adelaide, Davis 22. Maher 16. Blakemore 13 and Ninnis a dozen.
All right, no cheap stuff. They'll make some in between now and the end of the game to make sure it's hands up contested. All right, now we make these three throws. We're in five. Chris, if your man's taking the ball out of bounds, I want you in on a denial and then throw up. I want you up. All right? Any questions on anything? Continue to push the ball up the floor. We can't get this guy. All right, here we go.
Make some charges now. Let's go.
Let's go. Robert Rose has got his back to the camera, but he's urging on his teammates. Rose, as we've said a couple of times tonight, is out injured at the moment with a bad knee. He hurt his knee in week 7 when Adelaide hosted the Tigers. The MVP in the NBL last year when he was playing for the Magic. Now Blakemore at the line.
Lindsay Gaze in that timeout just said to his players, there is no shortcuts in offence. He said, run every play, play by play. He said, we don't need any 10 or 15 second offences. We'll run it right down to 30 seconds.
So it's 10 points the margin.
A little bit of pressure defence end by the Sixers. That's what they need. They have to make something happen in the game. They can't sit back and hope that it happens. It'll be a travel against Warwick Giddy. He went all the way, then found that he had nowhere to go. Tim, I wonder if you can find out some information on the Sixers bench about Robert Rose's injury and maybe when he is due to come back. Please, sir.
Anything, boss.
Blakemore to Ninnis. To Maher. Davis is free. Thought about the three. Goes inside for the two, stripped of the ball by Copeland. Good work. Gaze, can we have an alley-oop to Copeland? Tigers by 12.
Well, that'll keep you happy for another 3 or 4 weeks anyway.
I've got my fix. Maher down the middle.
Oh, great drive, great finish with the left hand straight over the top of Warwick Giddy. Tim Gossage, some news.
Well, the scoop. He played 40 minutes in a club game on Wednesday just to see how the injury was progressing. So you'd think that he'd be back next week. So there you go, Dean. Ask an expert.
Fantastic. Investigative reporter Tim Gossage.
Well, right on the spot. Much wrong with his knee if he was able to play 40 minutes. That's a good sign. Tim, oh, big block from Simmons. Tim, you forgot to tell us how many he shot and what was his percentage shooting from the field and how many rebounds he got.
I'm not too good with the stats, as we've found out in the past.
That's six blocked shots by Willie Simmons in his comeback game to the NBL. And from what Tim Gossage had said, it might be a short comeback, but that's a great defensive effort, and he really stretched for that one. Six blocks and 12 rebounds. 9 points. Great effort by the big wheel. Ex-Giant, ex-Cannon.
Copeland, oh, very sweet.
Right over the top of Simmons, in your face. That is just a super hoop. Gee whiz, he took it straight at the big fella.
The Tigers able to answer every challenge at the moment. Ninnis, oh, good assist to Davis. No foul call.
Davis is so strong underneath the basket. David Simmons did an excellent job to change the shot then. But Davis has got the ball back. He's got a vice-like grip. And stuck it back in the basket. Hanging in there, just 10 points. Need a break. They get aggressive.
To Bradtke. Fouls on Davis.
Unfortunately there, Willie Simmons was in the double team at the top of the key. Once the ball went off, he didn't work hard enough to get back. He really needed to work hard. Maybe tied. Third personal against Mark Davis.
Chris Blakemore is sitting down with a bruised left buttock.
Are they getting the magic sprayer?
True story, but I think he was going to be subbed out anyway, but he was complaining that it was a little tender.
Thanks for that, Tim. Much appreciated.
Four and a half left in the game. It's Melbourne leading Adelaide by 11. Simmons with the basketball. Back to Maher. Almost runs into his teammate, McKay. McKay gets it to Simmons inside. And the Molly Duca misses that one. Now Giddy comes away with the ball.
Well, that's just a couple of feet outside the range of that little lefty. Big screen set by Bradtke for Copeland. Simmons. Setting up the play. Away they go. Here comes Simmons. Going to have to look for a shot soon. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Good hands by Mark Davis. Slaps the ball clear.
McKay needs to nail it, and does. Well, it's 8 points of difference, so Adelaide aren't tossing it in by any means. Fouls on McKay. Wasn't exactly sure what that was for. Let's have a look.
Well, context there. I think it's just sort of the time.
Yeah,
push there, but it can't be too harsh. I mean, the contact was definitely there. Gay's heading for yet another 40-point game.
He's already above his season and career average. He's up to 38. 16 from 17 at the foul line tonight. 98-88. McKay, another three-point bomb. Short arms it. Simmons fails to get the rebound. Copeland comes up with the basketball. To Giddy. Back to Bradtke, outside to Copeland. Tigers just in no hurry. Gaze. Will he shoot over the top of Maher? No, he gives it to Bradtke. The Tigers working down that clock. Fouls on Ninnis for pushing. For holding.
Scotty Ninnis complaining that he was actually pushed in the first place, which caused him to push Copeland. The domino effect.
And a timeout called by Adelaide. They're down by 10 points with 3:03 left in the game. Gaze 38, Copeland 21, really had an excellent second half. Simmons 17, Bradtke 15 for Adelaide. Davis 24, Maher 18, Blakemore 15, Ninnis a dozen. Mike Dunlap, what can he do? Let's listen in.
All right. Go with box scramble. Guys, step out, cross pick here, right in there, all right, down pick, I just want something in tight, cross pick, and down pick, dribble entry into it, they're switching the stop, so just roll back off the pick, roll back off the pick, now, just because I made that mention, the second time you touch the ball, you're open, I want you to shoot it, all right, it's just a point that needed to be made. Defensively, when we make the basket, we're up. Everybody is up. Side denial, we're into it. All right? Man taking the ball out of bounds. You are trapping. Don't leave your trap. I want you to go in. Even if they throw it long, run it down and trap. Whoever's guarding the ball out of bounds, run the ball down and trap. All right? We have got to be on the move. But we still have 10 to 15 seconds each possession to get good shots. Screen on the ball if you're a big guy, especially you. I want you out high to start off with, and then down screen.
Dean Templeton, can you decipher? Box scramble, roll off the pick. What does all this mean?
Excellent coach speak. Really, really was some of the best coach speak I've ever heard. And it's secret. It's sort of like the Magician's Club.
So in other words, you got no idea what he was talking about.
I know exactly what he meant.
What he did say, fellas, I'll try and decipher it for you. He said, once they score, the Super Sixers, that is, must put pressure on the ball from every inbounds pass at all stages. He said, we must force some turnovers. That's the bit I understood. I didn't understand much more apart from that.
But he did better than us.
I have been impressed, though. Sorry, Dean. I have been impressed with the way Dunlap coaches. I mean, he's very cool in the crisis. I mean, his team's not out of it, and he has. It seems to me that he's got the respect of his players. That's one thing.
Yes, he certainly comes with the experience and the credentials to do the job.
Maher gets the pass to Ninnis and a blocking foul on Wazza.
Well, Wazza wasn't there until it was too late in that particular case. You see him jump up here, bang, there he comes, and good decision. But really, what the Sixers need right now is to make it happen. They've got to knock some shots down and they've got to get some pressure defense out there. That's what they've got to get to happen. And at the moment, the Tigers are the team that are putting the defensive pressure on. They've stepped up the pace a little bit. Simmons comes off his man to look for the double team. Good defense by the Tigers. Ninnis.
Bradtke slaps it out. Ninnis for three. Gaze, clever, to Copeland. Maher gets back. But Copeland still manages to get the two. Great work, Gaze.
Always thinking, always. Decided just the tip over the back, the head would do the job. Aware of where his players are, his teammates. Great play, Andrew Gaze, and great finish, Lanard Copeland. What a combination.
Has Copeland had a second half? He had six at half time, and he's had 19 in the second half. And they did put the pressure on Gaze in that third quarter. Copeland responded. McKay for three. McKay's up to double figures. But they still trail Adelaide by 11.
An interesting sideline. Something that I thought Tim Gossage would pick up quarters, actually. That was Lanard Copeland's 2,000th point. Or it's actually 2,001 points in the NBL on that last layup. So congratulations to Lanard Copeland.
And all that in just 79, well, make it 80 games of basketball now. Look at that, Gaze over the head.
Make the Australian volleyball team next, won't he? Look at that finish. Finger roll over the top, Copeland. Tigers really, after the slow start in the first quarter, never much in doubt.
Robert Rose is out of his seat again. Robert Rose has jumped over the advertising hoarding, wants to get out there. There's nothing wrong with the knee.
Oh, there was a foul. Let's have a look. There's the foul. Now they call the goaltending on Bradtke.
So Giddy.
So the basket counts. Giddy gets the foul. Davis goes to the line to finish the three-point play.
And Giddy fouls out. 102 to 94. 8-point margin with 1:15 left on the clock. So they really need a steal and a three here. Adelaide, but one thinks it's beyond them. Gaze. They'll be in no hurry, the Tigers. Oh, almost the intercept and the steal. Jump ball. But Gaze has worked down the clock very nicely. And it'll be a jump ball between Australian teammates, Mike McKay and Andrew Gaze. And that pair will be on their way to Canada later in the year for the World Basketball Championships. Plenty happening in Canada around August. Of course, the Commonwealth Games also happening. You can see all that action live and exclusive on Channel 10.
That's an interesting jump ball decision. Mark Davis reaching around David Simmons. Grab hold of the ball. Simmons made no attempt to get rid of the ball. Should have been a free kick the other way. Violation on the jump ball. So we're getting all sorts of decisions out here tonight.
Well, Bradtke ends up with the basketball. A lucky break for Melbourne. Double team. Fouls on Simmons or McKay. McKay puts his hand up. It is on McKay. It's all academic now.
Well, unfortunately, you know, this is the last 43 seconds of this game. We're going to probably take 3 or 4 minutes to play because teams insist on fouling even when realistically they have little chance of winning it.
It was interesting to see game four of the NBA game yesterday, Dean. There was about 18 seconds left on the clock and they were down by seven, and Knicks had the ball and Houston just let them roll it down, and none of this foul, stop, foul, start.
I suppose you get to a point where it becomes academic, as you said. Yeah. And with all due respect to the Sixers, I think it's academic. 103-94, under 40 seconds remaining.
Ninnis kicks it up outside, but right in the hands of Gaze. Gaze and Copeland. Gaze, point 40. 105-94. Davis. Copeland slaps it out of his hand. Simmons, a left hook. And that is goaltending against Dave Simmons, who's done very well to play good basketball on five fouls for just about a quarter and a bit. Copeland to Simmons. 10 seconds to go.
Jays, two more, and the Tigers are starting to celebrate. What a win for Melbourne. They were beaten last week by the Magic, but they've made amends tonight, knocking off the Adelaide Super Sixers by 11 points, 107-96, and no doubt about the star tonight. It's the expectant father, Andrew Gaze, with 42 points, 4 assists, 2 steals, and 7 rebounds. For Adelaide, Davis led the way with 27, and Maher had an excellent game with 21. But the Tigers, too good on the night. 107-99. 8-point victory in the end. Willie Simmons, it was far from disgraced, had an excellent game for Adelaide. And Tim Gossage is now speaking with Andrew Gaze, 42 points. And Tim, is Melinda on her way to the hospital yet?
Well, I'm just going to ask the player now. Stephen Quartermain wants to know, is Melinda on the way to the hospital?
I don't know. I don't know where she sits.
Nor do we. We've been looking for her for ages. She might have gone.
Mate, I've got absolutely everything. I've tried hot food. I've tried shaking her. I've got her doing star jumps every day. It just won't come out. Life's too good in there.
Certainly is. Well, I mean, how did you concentrate on this game? Very well, it looked like. 42 points yourself.
Yeah, well, sometimes those sort of things have a reverse effect on you. They take the mind off the game, you're concentrating on things, other things, and you come out and you just play to your natural instincts. And I think that's what happened tonight, you know, because I have been a little bit high strung waiting for that thing to come out.
Well, how's Melinda feeling at this stage, watching a performance like that? It really was a team performance.
Yeah, it was. We played great basketball tonight. You know, they come out strong, and they're a tough team to play against because they use the ball so well on offense. It's very frustrating that every time down the court they take 30 seconds up. So it's good to finally break the shackles and get away from them.
Just a couple of quick ones, and I'm back on that subject again, baby. What's it going to be called? Give us a hint.
If it's a boy, I'm going to call it Jalen. And if it's a girl, I'm going to call it Courtney. Only because I watch Melrose Place and one of the chicks on the show.
You're a man after my own heart. Well done. Congratulations. Andrew Gaze, a Melrose Place watcher. And why not? It's on Channel 10, Stephen.
And Courtney. I'll just take off the anyone. You've got Courtney. You've got that basketball link too. Excellent interview. Tim Gossage with Andrew Gaze. We'll be back to wrap up in just a moment. An 8-point win to the Melbourne Tigers over the Adelaide Sixers, 107-99. And Dino, after half time, I guess the result was never in doubt. Tigers just too good.
Well, Adelaide came out of the blocks very well. Another slow start to the Tigers, but they really did start to get on top as the game went on and wore them down. Andrew Gaze, what can you say about the guy? Another tremendous game, and Copeland came strong, came good in that second half. Let's have a look at the stats. Field goal percentage, well, exactly the same for both teams. Free throw percentage edged to the Tigers. 3-point percentage, in unusually much better than the field goal percentage for both clubs, so that's pretty good. Rebounding edge to the Tigers, and turnovers about the same. But good win to the Tigers.
Yeah, an excellent interview with Andrew Gaze after the game. Tim, it's 42 points, and what a superstar he is. He just does it every week.
The consummate professional. To have that on his mind is the birth of his first child and still knock up 42 points. A fantastic performance. But Lanard Copeland also stepped up. He finished with 25, some 17 behind Gaze, and they also got double-figure jobs from Simmons and Bradtke. Davis, well, he knocked up 27, Maher 21, Blakemore 15, had a very good second half, Ninnis 12 and Simmons 11, so a good spread of scorers there for the Sixers, but not good enough.
Well, let's have a look at what's coming up on Channel 10 over the weekend as far as basketball is concerned. Saturday basketball includes all the NBA and NBL action hosted by the dynamic duo Billy Woods and Steve Carfino, Saturday 12 noon to 2 p.m. Some big games tomorrow night. Kings up against the Giants. What a battle that will be. Magic playing the Wildcats, and we have the news through from Hobart, an absolute sensation. Hobart have defeated Perth by 1 point. Incredible. Hawks up against the Supercats. Bullets playing Newcastle, and the Cannons play Adelaide. Sunday basketball, a comprehensive review of the weekend in basketball between 12 noon and 2:30. So we hope you've enjoyed the action tonight. We'll be here again tomorrow night at Flinders Park for the Magic playing the Perth Wildcats. Until we see you again then, it's good night. Let's get it.